Registered Phenomena Code 100. Object Class Beta Orange. Hazard Types: Organic Hazard, Sapient Hazard, Aggression Hazard. Containment Protocols: RPC-100 is to be contained in an artificial temperate rainforest habitat, with 60% of the habitat's surface submerged in water. Every 3 days, an adult pig is to be released in the RPC-100's containment chamber. Biweekly maintenance is to be held to ensure no holes or openings greater than 6 cm in diameter lead out of RPC-100's chamber. Description: RPC-100 is a large organism resembling a cephalopod, more specifically an octopus. RPC-100's natural skin color is a dark brown, ideal for camouflaging in its natural muddy habitat. However, like most cephalopods, it can change its color at will. Unlike an octopus or any other cephalopod, RPC-100 possesses lungs rather than gills, allowing it to breathe on land. Also, unlike other cephalopods, RPC-100 only possesses 4 arms. Each arm is approximately 15 meters in length, with an average of about 100 arm-like tendrils splitting from the base arm. Each of these tendrils can be individually controlled by RPC-100, as if they were a smaller arm. While RPC-100 does not require sustenance, if not given the opportunity to hunt, it will become highly irritable, tending to attack the walls of its containment chamber when in such a state. RPC-100 is capable of causing immense damage with its arms, far more than what should be possible given the arm's composition. These two factors make providing RPC-100 with something to hunt imperative to its continued containment. RPC-100 has shown considerable intelligence and problem-solving skills, even in comparison to other cephalopods and primates. It is capable of solving most puzzles given to it, and is able to escape any containment chamber with openings larger than its relatively small beak, which is 6 cm in width. It has shown in testing that it is capable of making its escape regardless of the number of traps or puzzles that are placed in its way, nor the complexity of said obstacles. This intelligence also gives it far greater control over its camouflage, allowing it to become practically invisible. RPC-100's intelligence is far higher than the lower-level versions of this article would indicate. RPC-100's actual intelligence far surpasses that of any humans. This was, however, not always the case. RPC-100 was first identified in 19… At the time of discovery, RPC-100 was a four-armed cephalopod that possessed lungs rather than gills. It demonstrated above-average intelligence, with problem-solving skills on par with a human toddler. Due to the light containment requirements, it was classified as Alpha and contained in a 100-liter aquarium in Site-027, where it remained for… years. In 2000, authority personnel became suspicious of Site-027's low activity, besides weekly messages requesting more CSD personnel. Upon reaching site, it was found the site had suffered heavy damage, and had been largely reclaimed by nature. This, coupled with the fact the site was consistently sending out normal operational messages, caused theories of Site-027 being affected by unclassified reality-altering phenomenon. However, exploration of the site revealed RPC-100 within the site's control room, broadcasting the all-clear messages. It was discovered far larger than its original size, with hundreds of smaller tendrils splitting from the main arms. RPC-100 was then heavily sedated and brought to its current containment location. RPC-100's anatomy shows how it managed to take control of Site-027. The tendrils along RPC-100's arms seems to contain heavily degenerated human organ systems. These tendrils do possess degenerated human brains, all of which are connected to RPC-100's main brain. However, these brains still seem to be partially independently controlled. However, this control is limited purely to instinct and emotion, and not control of any body parts or access to any sensory organs. Analysis of the brain waves emitted from these has shown they are in a considerable state of distress and fear. It is also considered likely that RPC-100 is able to control the senses of these brains, sending what could be likened to torture to prevent these lesser brains from assuming any kind of control. For these reasons, RPC-100's true classification is Gamma Red, and that threat level will be rising should containment ever be compromised. Its continued containment is imperative to the continued autonomy of the human race. However, its true nature is to be kept classified to prevent mass panic, either within the Authority or the general public. Addendum 100A On 2000, a maintenance crew entered RPC-100's containment chamber to repair a 7 cm hull. While the hull was repaired, the crew did not exit the containment chamber and no bodies were recovered. Due to this, any personnel entering RPC-100's containment chamber are to exercise extreme caution. Director's Notice: I'd like to advise staff not to attempt communication with RPC-100. It may be intelligent, but it won't be intelligent enough to understand you. Due to the potential damage doing this may cause, attempting communications with RPC-100 is grounds for termination. Director: